Right, students. Now the same exercise will continue the problem number 9. What is problem number 9? Show that each relation R in the given set A is equal to set of x belongs to Z. Z values are in between 0 to 12, including 0 and including 12. And given two relations here. First subdivision is R is equal to set of ordered pair A comma B such that mod of A minus B is a multiple of 4. Previous problem we did mod of A minus B is an even. Now mod of A minus B is a multiple of 4. Multiple of 4 means you know very well it is divisible by 4 exactly. Correct or not? 4 multiples. 4, 8, 12, 16, like those are all multiples of 4. Next, second subdivision is given, R is equal to set of ordered pairs such that A equal to B, A, B are equal. That condition we are going to prove whether it is a equivalence relation or not. That is the first condition. Till more is their problem. First we will show that whether it is equivalence relation or not. Right, any relation you want to prove equivalence, definitely it should be a reflexive, symmetric and transitive relation. Correct or not? Right, students, first we are going to prove it is an equivalence relation. Then we have the little more, find the set of all elements related to one in each case. After complete the problem, we have to go to the second part. Now, first subdivision, R is equal to, first you are going to write given set. Here given set A equal to set of x belongs to Z such that 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 12. What does it mean? A is equal to set of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. These are the possible integers according to the given set. They told 0 to 12, in between all integers, including 0, including 12. So these are all integers in between 0, 12, including 0 means 0 also added, including 12 means 12 is also added. This is the given set. On this particular set, first subdivision, given relation. R equal to set of ordered pair A comma B such that mod of A minus B is a multiple of 4. This we are going to prove. This particular relation undefined in this set, this relation is equivalence or not, you are going to prove. If it is an, show that they told definitely it is an equivalence. If it is a equivalence, it should satisfy reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Right. Now we will check the reflexive. Theoretical example. If AB is belongs to in this relation, mod of A minus B is a multiple of 4. If suppose reflexive means we are going to take AA, if AA belongs to R, mod of A minus A is 0, 0 is a multiple of 4. Why? Because 4 zeros are 0. 4 is exactly divisible by A. 0 is exactly divisible by 4. So 0 is also multiple of 4 only. So R is reflexive, true. R is reflexive relation. If it is a reflexive, you have to give it an example. Not example, you have to give the definition. As A comma A belongs to R, for all small a belongs to capital A. According to the given relation, if any ordered pair in that particular relation, their absolute difference is multiple of 4. Absolute means modulus. Now, the given ordered pair is 0, 0. Absolute value of A minus A is mod of 0, which is 0. 0 is a multiple of 4. True. If it is true, therefore R is a reflexive relation. R is a reflexive relation on set A. Right. Now we are proving the symmetric. What is the definition of symmetric? If AB belongs to R, there must be B also. If AB belongs to R, according to this relation, mod of A minus B is multiple of 4. Mod of A minus B is a multiple of 4. Obviously, mod of B minus A is also multiple of 4. Let I am taking A is equal to 4, B is equal to 8. 4 minus 8, modulus, mod minus 4, that is nothing but 4, is a multiple of 4. If you take 8 minus 4, 4 minus 8, 8 minus 4, A minus B, B minus A. Obviously, it is also multiple of 4. So, definitely, R is a symmetric always. So, R is a symmetric. R is a symmetric relation. Students, you remember important thing, when the relation is satisfied, you should not explain with an example. You should not explain with an example. You have to take the definition and prove it. If it is fails, you have to give with an example. Property fail, then you have to give with an example. Property not failed and property satisfies, you have to prove by using definition. Should not use example. Be careful. Okay, now we have to go through the definition. What is definition? As ordered pair AB belongs to R, that implies if particular ordered pair is belongs to a particular relation, what is the relation condition? Mod of A minus B is multiple of 4. Mod of A minus B is a multiple of 4. Now, I can write mod of A minus B as 1 minus common factor, mod of B minus A is a multiple of 4. Did you understood? I took just minus common from here. These two are interchanges. Mod of minus value becomes a plus value. So, mod of B minus A is a multiple of 4. So, if mod of B minus A is a multiple of 4, obviously B comma A is also belongs to in that relation. If you are taken AB in that particular relation, you proved BA is also in the particular relation. Hence, R is a symmetric relation on set A. Now we are going to check the transitive relation. What is meant by transitive? AB and BC belongs to R. There must AC also. Is it clear? AB and BC is possible. Then AC must possible. AB possible means AB ordered pair. If AB ordered pair is belongs to that particular relation, mod of A minus B is a multiple of 4. BC ordered pair is belongs to that particular relation, mod of B minus C is a multiple of 4. If A minus B is a multiple of 4, B minus C is a multiple of 4. So, 4 is a multiple of 4, 8 is a multiple of 4. Sum of those two is also a multiple of 4. 4 plus 8 is equal to 12 as a multiple of 4. But you should not give it an example in the examination. You have to give the definition. Definition you have to use and prove it. Now, A minus B is a multiple of 4, B minus C is a multiple of 4, then A minus B plus B minus C is a multiple of 4, minus B and plus B gets cancelled, A minus C as a multiple of 4. If A minus C is a multiple of 4, obviously mod of A minus C is also multiple of 4, AC belongs to R, hence it is a transitive relation. Like that we are going to explain. Let us see here. R is transitive relation. It is a relation, you have to prove by using definition. As AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R, if AB is in particular ordered pair present in that relation, given relation, their absolute difference is a multiple of 4. Absolute difference means modulus of the difference. Let I can write here mod of a minus b is a multiple of 4. And b minus b comma c is also belongs to that particular relation. So we can write mod of b minus c is a multiple of 4. So if you remove the modulus, it is also the same condition. A minus b is a multiple of 4 and b minus c is a multiple of 4. So if 2 are the multiples of 4, if 2 numbers are multiples of 4, their sum is also multiple of 4 only. Now we will check that. So a minus b plus a minus c, b minus c are multiple of 4. So we can cancel plus b and minus b. A minus c is a multiple of 4. If a minus c is a multiple of 4, mod of a minus c is a multiple of 4. So obviously a comma c is belongs to particular relation R. Hence R is a transitive relation. Hence R is a transitive relation. So the relation should satisfy here reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Any relation satisfies reflexive, symmetric and transitive, which is an equivalence relation. R satisfies reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Hence it is an equivalence relation. So first part is completed. Still we have two more parts that we will discuss here. The second part is find the set of all elements related to 1 in each case. So here given the first set is what are the possible elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. In these elements, which element is related to 1 should satisfy the given condition. Now the set of all elements related to 1. How to write that? Set of small a belongs to capital A such that AB belongs to that particular relation R. Instead of writing AB, we will write as A1. Why? Because we need all elements related to 1. Now according to the relation small a belongs to capital A, if any ordered pair is belongs to in that particular relation, their difference is a multiple of 4. So you can write mod of a minus 1 is a multiple of 4. You check which values are substituting instead of a place in the particular set, this must be satisfied. That means small a, there is a possibility of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So these are all instead of a place. But the second element is it is fixed because which elements are related to 1. That means second element is already fixed with 1. First element A place, you can take any number from A, but they must satisfy this condition. What is that condition? Their difference must be a multiple of 4. Suppose I will substitute A place is 0, 0 minus 1, mod of minus 1 is plus 1 is not a multiple of 4. Suppose if you substitute 1, 1 minus 1, 0 is a multiple of 4. Yes, it is true, 4 zeros are 0. So that particular set you are getting 1 is one element. Next 2, you can check it. 2 minus 1, 1. It is not a multiple of 4. It won't divide it by 4. So you can check with 2, 3, 3 minus 1, 2 is not a multiple of 4. You can check with 5, 5 minus 1 is a multiple of 4. Yes, 5 minus 1, 4, 4 is exactly divisible by 4. So the next element is 5. Next, you can check with 6. 6 minus 1, 5, it won't satisfy. You can check with 7, 7 minus 1, it won't satisfy. Like, you can check with 7 minus 1 is 6, it won't satisfy. 8 minus 1 is 7, it won't satisfy. 9 minus 1 is 8, 8 is exactly divisible by 4. 8 is a multiple of 4, so 1, 5, 9. Now, we have one more 10. 10 minus 1, 9 is not a multiple of 4. 11 minus 1, 10 is not a multiple of 4. 12 minus 1, 11 is not a multiple of 4. Among all the elements, 1 is related only these 3 elements. Did you understood? Because if you take with 1, 1, 5, 1 or 1, 5, 9, 1 or 1, 9, those ordered pairs only can satisfy the given condition. Their difference, absolute difference, is a multiple of 4. So these are the elements related to 1. Clear, students? Right. Right, students. So we completed a 9th problem, first subdivision. There is a second subdivision. What is the second subdivision? R is a relation. R is equal to set of ordered pair A comma B such that A equal to B. Previously we completed ordered pair A comma B such that modulus of A minus B is a multiple of 4. Here A is equal to B is the condition in this relation, but the set is the same. This relation is also defined the same set. What is that set? We are taking integers from 0 to 12, including 0, including 12. So given set A is equal to set of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now, we are given relation R is equal to set of ordered pair A comma B such that A equal to B. Before going to this problem, we want to prove it is also an equivalence relation. What is given condition here? First ordered pair and second. In ordered pair, first element and second element, there is an equal to relation. Previously, it is a absolute value difference is multiple of 4. Equality relation is an equivalence relation always. Why? Because if you take ordered pair A comma B, there is A is equal to B condition. If you take ordered pair A comma A means that is reflexive. A is equal to A. Yes, it is obviously satisfied, so it is a reflexive. Suppose you want to prove the symmetric relation, ordered pair AB is belongs to R, there must be A also. If AB belongs to R, according to our relation, A equal to B. If A equal to B, obviously B equal to A. If B is equal to A, BA also belongs to R, so it is also a symmetric. Now we will go through the transitive relation. If AB, BC ordered pairs are belongs to that particular relation, AC ordered pair is also belongs to that particular relation. If AB belongs to R, according to the given relation, A equal to B. If BC belongs to R, that means ordered pair BC belongs to R, then B equal to C. If A equal to B, B equal to C, obviously A equal to C, so transitive is also satisfied. Hence it is an equivalence relation. Always you remember equal to, similar to, congruence to, parallel to, these are all always equivalence relations. But when they are giving in the 3 marks question, you cannot say the orally it is an equivalence relation. You have to prove it theoretically by using their definitions. Right, students. Now we will check the reflexive. R is reflexive relation. Now we have to define by using definition. As a comma a belongs to R for all small a belongs to capital A, that implies if ordered pair a comma b given relation a is equal to b. Reflexive means instead of b place also a. If a comma a belongs to R, a is equal to a. It is true only. It is true for all small a belongs to capital A. Hence, R is a reflexive relation. Now, we have to check the symmetric relation. R is also symmetric. Just now I told, we will check it. R is a symmetric relation. Symmetric definition, recall it. As a comma b ordered pair is belongs to R. If ordered pair a b belongs to R, according to the rule a equal to b is the condition. If a is equal to b, obviously b is also equal to a. If a b ordered pair in that particular relation, a equal to b. If b equal to a, that particular ordered pair b a must in that relation. So AB belongs to R, that implies BA belongs to R. Therefore R is a symmetric relation on A. This is also on A. Now we have to check the transitive relation. Transitive means AB and BC both are belongs to R, then AC should be, that we are going to prove. According to the R is a transitive relation. As AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R, these two are possible, then only AC belongs to R. If ordered pair AB belongs to R, according to the given condition, A is equal to B and B is equal to C. A value is equal to B, B value is equal to C. Obviously, A value is also equal to C. If A equal to C, ordered pair AC is belongs to R. So, you are taken AB and BC belongs to R. You proved as AC belongs to R. Hence, R is a transitive relation on set A. So R is a reflexive satisfied, symmetric satisfied, transitive satisfied. So if a relation satisfies reflexive, symmetric and transitive, hence it is an equivalence relation. So R satisfies reflexive, symmetric and transitive, hence it is an equivalence relation. Hence it is an equivalence relation. We have the second part. What is in the second part? Here also write all the elements related to one. Now all the elements related to one, that means set of small a belongs to capital A such that a comma 1 belongs to R. We have to write R, small a values you have to pick from the set A. Set A, what are the elements? You know very well, from 0 to 12. Now second element is 1, because you have to write all the elements related to 1. All the elements related to 1 means which condition should satisfy in this relation? A equal to 1. This is the relation. Why? Because here the relation is A equal to B. A place is A, but B place is 1. A equal to 1. Which element instead of A place we will substitute, this relation will satisfy? If you substitute 0, 0 is not equal to 1. If you substitute 1, 1 is equal to 1. Other than 1, if you substitute any number instead of a place, it won't satisfy. So, set of 1 is the element related to 1 which satisfies the given relation. Understood, students? Thank you. Right, students, the continuity of 1.4, 10th problem. This is an important problem. They will ask just examples of a particular relations. What is a 10th problem? You just see here. Given an example of a relation, first subdivision, which is symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive. But a symmetric, it is a only symmetric, neither reflexive nor transitive. Should not be a transitive, should not be a reflexive, but only symmetric. You just take an example and write it. Let first subdivision, I am writing an example. Let A is equal to set of 1, 2. This you can assume your wish. 1, 2 or 1, 2, 3 or any elements you can assume it. Now, here also we can write one relation. While writing this relation, you should keep in your mind symmetric only. Neither reflexive nor transitive. Reflexive means you know very well each element of set A, there must be related to itself. Such elements are there, it is reflexive. And it should not be there such. Next, it is not transitive. What is transitive? AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R, then AC must. That also you have to see that. They are asking only symmetric. I can take ordered pair 1, 2 and 2, 1. The relation is closed. Now, 1 is present here, 1, 1 is not here, 2 is present here, 2, 2 is not here, so it is not reflexive. AB, BC, AC is not there. Why? Because AB is 1, 2, BC is 2, 1, whereas AC is 1, 1, 1, 1 is not present, it is not transitive, but AB belongs to R, at the same time BA also belongs to R, it is a symmetric. So, this is a best example for symmetric relation, neither reflexive nor transitive. So, I can write here, R is not reflexive. First write it here, reflexive. R is not reflexive. If the relation failed, you have to give it an example. 1 is belongs to A, but 1, 1 is not belongs to R. As X, X not belongs to R, for all small x belongs to A. So, reflexive not satisfied. Now, we will check the symmetric. What I told them, while writing reflexive, you should focus on set A, because each and every element of set A should participate in that relation. But each and every element should not participate in that relation. That's why it is not reflexive. While doing other relations, that means it may be a symmetric, it may be a transitive, it may be anti-symmetric, it may be asymmetric. All these are, ignore the set A. You have to concentrate or you have to focus on that relation. If you focus on the relation, there must be ordered pair 1, 2 as well as 2, 1, AB and BA, so it is a symmetric always. So R is a symmetric relation. Why it is a symmetric? As XY belongs to R, that implies YZ belongs to R. 1, 2 belongs to R, that implies 2, 1 belongs to R. So, the particular relation is a symmetric relation. X belongs to R, sorry. Right. Next, we will go through the transitive. You check this relation AB. What is a transitive? If AB and BC is possible, then only AC. AB possible? BC possible. AB is 1, 2, BC is 2, 1, whereas AC is 1, 1. 1, 1 is not possible here. That's why it is not a transitive relation. So it is not a transitive. So you have to give it an example. R is not a transitive. Give an example. As XY belongs to R and YZ belongs to R, but XZ is not belongs to R. Give an example. 1, 2 belongs to R. That implies 1, 2 belongs to R and 2, 1 belongs to R, but 1, 1 is not belongs to R. So R is neither reflexive nor transitive, but it is symmetric. So the first condition, that is only they are asking, give an example of a relation which is symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive. Yes, it is a reflexive, it is a symmetric, neither reflexive nor transitive relation.